the data warehouse, and why do we need a data warehouse?
Okay.
First of all, data warehouse is nothing but it is a place where we store the historical data for doing analysis. Assume that you have there are two types of systems. One is OLTP systems and OLAP systems. Okay. OLTP systems are nothing but these are the systems that are used to run your day-to-day business.
Okay.
So it can be ATM, and the data that we store from the OLTP systems will be inserted into the operational databases.
Okay.
And this operational database, it contains only current data. Database contains current data, because if you see, I said OLTP system example as ATM. If you go to the ATM and if you want to go and do some transaction, debit or credit, whatever it is, then if it takes 20 minutes or 30 minutes, so nobody will have a patience to wait there. Am I correct?
Okay. Yeah.
Right? So because, yeah. See, the time, when the time it will take, like only when you think that the operational database has some trillions of records.
Uh-huh.
Okay, when the operational database has some trillions, like a thousand millions of records.
Okay.
Assume that we are storing even the historical data in the operational database.
Okay,
assume historical data is in operational database. So now we'll see what happens. So what happens when you try to insert a record into the operational database? So when you do a transaction, a record will be inserted. So when there are many number of records, then to check everything, it will take time.
Yeah.
See, when the database is very big, then, and also if everybody is using the database for insertions and retrievals.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, then what happens, then whatever the transaction that you do, it will take time to get it finished.
Okay.
Right? So yeah. That is the reason. So since that ATM is used for your day-to-day business, and if the transaction takes so much of time, then no user will have a patience to wait there. And it will affect your actual business.
Yeah.
So in order to avoid such type of scenarios, and what we do is, in the operational database, we do not store the historical data. We only keep the current data. So maximum of it contains only 1 week data. If you go to the ATM, and if you see the mini statement, you can get the mini statement only. You cannot get the detailed statement.
Yeah.
Right? So see, it contains only current data.
Okay.
Then to do the analysis, current data is not sufficient, right? For example, in order to check whether how your business is performing, then the current data would not suffice, right? So you should have the historical data. See, to see whether your business is performing well or not in the last 2 years, then you should have the data of last 2 years. Am I correct or wrong?
Yeah.
Right? So now this historical data, it has to be kept at some place. So that is the place we call it as a data warehouse.
Okay.
So data warehouse is a place where we store the historical data for doing analysis. So by doing analysis, you can improve the business.
Okay.
So now, and data warehouse, it is the centralized repository, and whatever the data that your business is capturing on a daily basis, so the complete data, we generally load it into the data warehouse. So it is like whatever the data your business captures, like in your business, you'll have multiple OLTP systems like SAP R/3. So SAP R/3 applications running on in your business, and you'll have something Oracle Financial.
Okay.
And something like ADP HR system. So you'll have different source systems, and suppose Salesforce. So these are the different applications that will be running on a daily basis, and which captures the data using which we can run the business.
Okay.
Business. Now the complete entire data from the different source systems, what we do is we integrate them and we populate them into the data warehouse.
Okay.
So let me draw the small diagram here. So assume that this is one source system.
Okay.
This is another source system. This is another source system. So source system, like for example, Salesforce, SAP R/3 applications, and Oracle Financials. So each source system is of different database.
Okay.
Okay. This is Oracle, and see, even if the mainframe is also a source system. So
yeah.
Like core mainframe is the OLTP, right?
Yeah.
So we are getting assumed that the mainframe size files even. Something like DB2,
yeah.
Yeah. So now daily your to daily whatever the data that that we are capturing to run our business is sitting in these three source systems. Now what
okay.
we have to do is we have to integrate the data and we have to store it in the centralized repository, which we call it as a data warehouse.
Okay.
Okay. So now extract the data from the different source systems. And load them into the data warehouse. So to do this, we need some set of ETL tools. So extracting
okay.
the data and loading it into the data warehouse. So directly we cannot do it. So earlier days, what they used to do is they used to write the stored procedures for achieving this.
Yeah.
Okay. So, but the thing is, if you go with the stored procedures, then what happens is to achieve a simple task, we need to write some thousands lines of code, and it becomes very difficult to maintain. Suppose tomorrow, if you have to change a small part, then you have to go and do the debugging, like what, where I need to fix it. Okay.
Okay.
And in the stored procedure, what happens is you use the more number of temporary tables to do the transformations and all.
Okay.
So because of the temporary tables, like what happens, the performance gets degraded. And to address your simple business requirement, it will take more time.
Yeah.
So these are the some disadvantages which we are having if you go with the traditional methods. So it is a traditional method, writing the stored procedure for implementing the ETL projects. Okay. Hello.
Yeah. I'm hearing.
So now nowadays there are many number of ETL tools available in the market, and one among them is IBM DataStage.
Okay.
Okay. So ETL stands for E for extraction. T for transformation and L for loading. So you have to, using this tool, what we do is we extract the data from the different source systems.
Okay.
And before loading the data into the data warehouse, we do some sort of transformations. So transformations like, I mean to say data transformations. So the data will not be directly going sit into the data warehouse.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. So we do the data cleansing. Data cleansing is a transformation.
Okay.
Okay, if there are any duplicates, then removing the duplicates, it is a data cleansing, part of data cleansing. So
okay.
Removing the dirty data if you have any. Okay. And data scrubbing we have.
Okay.
So data scrubbing is nothing but like converting the data into the desired format, some sort of
okay.
scrubbing kind of thing. Okay.
Yeah.
So you have the data, you need to transform it. For example, I'm having the like from the mainframe file, I'm getting the date of birth in Julian date format.
Okay.
Now what I need to do is I need to transform it into format like CYYY/MM/DD.
Okay.
So this is called as a transformation.
Yeah.
Okay. So we do the transformations using the ETL tools, and then we populate the data into the data warehouse.
Okay.
Yeah. So to address your business requirement, in data stage we create jobs.
Okay.
So we create the jobs to address your business requirement. So simple example for a job is, extract the data from a pipe delimited file and populate it into a table.
Okay,
this data warehouse is nothing but it is also a database. So in that data warehouse we'll have dimension tables and the fact tables. So now what I'm saying, extract the data from the pipe delimited file and populate it into a dimension table.
Okay.
So this is your business requirement. Now to address this business requirement, what we have to do is we need to create a job in the data stage.
Yeah, I got it.
You got it, right?
Yeah.
So now in the data stage, we have three types of jobs. One is server job, second one is parallel jobs, and third one is sequence jobs. So if you see, if you go to any project, okay, first they will ask you is whether do you have any experience. Say that nowadays everybody, they are using the parallel jobs.
Okay.
So in previous, like six years back, so in the project they used to create the server jobs.
Okay.
So the difference between the server job and the parallel job is, in the parallel job you can achieve high degree of parallelism.
Okay.
So high degree of parallelism can be achieved.
Parallelism means?
Parallelism in the sense, for example, like the if you go with the same above example, extract the data from the pipe delimited file and populate it into the table. Now assume that the file contains 100 million records.
Okay.
So now one after like so what we have to do is we need to read each and every record sequentially.
Okay.
And then we need to insert the data into the table. For example, like assume that there is a small transformation involved, like this date of birth transformation has to be applied before populating the data into the database table. So every record it has to be transformed. So instead of doing it sequentially, record by record, what I can do is, so in the data stage, what it will do, there is, we can add your more number of processes.
Okay.
And this 100 million records, what we can do, we can partition it.
Okay.
So assume that now I have four processors. So each processor will take some set of records and it will process it. Suppose I am partitioning this data into four sets.
Okay.
Now each set will contain 25 million records. Now each 25 million records will be processed by one processor. Now initially if 100 million records was taking 20 minutes to populate. So now it will be reduced by four. Since you have four processors, each processor will process one set of five.
Okay.
So this will happen internally. So you will not create, data stage engine will take care of all these things, applying the partitioning.
Okay.
So this is a parallelism. So because the parallelly you are operating.
Yeah.
Right? So because of this partitioning parallelism, you can reduce the processing speed, processing time.
Okay.
So this partitioning parallelism, we can achieve it in the parallel jobs. By default, we can achieve it in the parallel jobs. And second point is another type of parallelism we have. So when I say that it is, we can achieve high degree of parallelism, it means we can achieve pipeline parallelism and partition parallelism. So we have looked at partition parallelism. Now let me give you an example for the pipeline parallelism. So in the job contains stages. We have each stage to do a simple task. For example, if you want to read the data from the file, we have a sequential file stage. So then you have to transform the data, we have something called as transformer stage. So here you will have some set of stages, you need to configure the stage And okay. to populate the data into your table, we have some DB2 connector.
So okay.
data stage job contains stages. We have to relate each stage. We have to link each stage to accomplish your business requirement. Now here what is happening? The first stage will read the data that is there in your pipe delimiter file and it will okay. keep it in the buffer.
Okay.
Okay. And once the data is loaded into the buffer, then the second stage will read the data from the buffer and it will apply the transformation on every record and again it will keep it in the buffer.
Okay, so one doubt. Is it happening one by one or the
That is about the pipeline parallelism.
Okay.
Okay, so if it happens one by one, like only when the complete data is read and kept into the buffer, so don't you see that these two stages are becoming ideal?
Yeah.
Right, so the pipeline parallelism, what happens is, so as soon as the data is there in the buffer, like for example, if you have 100 million records, then at one stretch, if you are reading 5,000 records and keeping it in the buffer,
okay,
instead of waiting for another millions of records, what we can do is we can, second stage can fetch the 5,000 records from the buffer and it can process.
Yeah.
Right? So because of that, the time, okay, again, yeah. the processing time gets reduced.
Okay.
Right? Because simultaneously, both the stages will be operating.
Okay. So both pipeline and partition parallelism happens, right?
Yes. Both pipeline and partition, these two can be achieved. By default, it will be there in the parallel jobs.
Okay.
So because of this parallelism, the processing time, whatever the job takes, it will be reduced drastically.
Yeah.
And this parallelism, by default, we cannot achieve in the server jobs.
Okay.
So this is the main difference, and the second difference between the server job and the parallel job is, to do a simple task, there is a stage in parallel job.
Okay.
So parallel jobs contains many number of stages. So, but whereas the server job very less number of stages.
Okay.
So we have to use only those stages and the job becomes more complex. So to design the server job, it is a little difficult than creating the parallel job. Okay.
Yeah.
And coming to the sequence jobs in the sense, like suppose assume that you have two COBOL programs and one COBOL program is finished, then you need to run the second COBOL program.
Yeah.
Okay. So these two, you will link it in which will you, I mean, there will be some wrapper kind of thing. So workflow, where we can define the workflow.
Okay.
So, I mean, so that is like in mainframe also we have that. And the same way here also, suppose you have created job one, job two and job three.
Okay.
So my requirement is I have to run job one, job two, at the same time. First I need to run the job one, job two simultaneously, and when job one and job two gets finished, when both the jobs get finished, then I should run job three. It is like a scheduling kind of thing.
Okay, I got it. Yeah.
Okay, workflow manager.
Yeah.
Okay. So now to define your workflow, so we create the sequence jobs.
Okay.
So sequence job is nothing but it is a job in which we defines the workflow. Okay. Now, so to develop server job or parallel job or sequence jobs, so in data stage, there is a client component called as designer.
Okay.
So from the designer, we create the server jobs, parallel jobs and sequence jobs. And another client component is director. So there are three client components which we have. One is data stage designer, data stage director, and third one is data stage administrator.
Okay.
And from the director, what we can do is we can monitor the jobs that are executed.
Okay.
Okay, you can monitor what is happening inside the job.
Okay.
Okay. And we can also see the logs.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, logs can be, you can find, if you want to schedule the jobs, we can schedule it. Suppose you have created one sequence job. Now this is the sequence job. Job 1, job 2, job 3. And this sequence job, you want to run it so that when the sequence job gets executed, it will trigger job 1, job 2. And then when these two finish, then it will trigger job 3. So then we have to trigger the batch job, right? So that batch job, we can schedule it from the data stage director client component.
Okay.
Okay. So scheduling. So data stage director component is used for monitoring the jobs, executing the jobs and scheduling the jobs. Whereas this administrator component, we use it for, first we use it for creating the projects.
Okay.
So first you will create one ETL project and then you will give, you will like if you want to enforce any security.
Okay.
Then you use this administrator, like you do not want to give rights to everybody to do read and write permission, only read permissions you want to give, like protecting the projects, that we can do it from the data stage administrator.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, so all admin kind of, all admin related things, we perform it from the data stage administrator.
Okay, yeah, okay. Got it.
So now, till this point, is it clear?
Yeah. One doubt I have.
Yes.
When you say sequence jobs, we'll be having both the parallel jobs and sequence jobs, right?
Correct. So you can use the parallel as well as server, and even you can use the sequence in a sequence.
Okay. So is the sequence job used to call the parallel job?
Yes. In the sequence job, we have a stage, job activity stage. What it will do is it will execute the data stage jobs.
Okay.
So when I say it as a data stage jobs, it can be a server, parallel, sequence.
Okay.
Okay, so one sequence can trigger another sequence.
Okay,
is it clear enough?
Yeah, I got it. Yeah.
So now let me show you the components, how it looks like. Okay?
Okay.
So this demo session is completely to give you an overview idea, like what is a data stage and to showcase my capabilities.
Okay.
Okay. I'll just connect to my remote machine. Hello, Teja. Teja. Thank you. Justin, I will connect you to my VPN from Tejas machine, okay?
Okay.
Yeah. From here it is not responding. So let me change the presenter to Teja.
Okay.
Hello? ఓకే లేదు మీరు క్లోజ్ చేయండి మీరు ప్రెసెంటర్ తీస్తే నేను తీసుకుంటాను అయితే నన్ను ప్రెసెంటర్ చేయరా యా జస్టిన్ ఐ విల్ మేక్ యూ యాజ్ ఎ ప్రెసెంటర్
ఓకే
ఓకే And I will take the access from your machine.
Okay.
Just click on show my screen.
Okay.
I'll request you for access. One second. అది నాకు యాక్సెస్ రావట్లేదండి అది నేను ఆర్గనైజర్ చేస్తూనే వస్తుందేమో నాకు తెలిసి ఆయన ప్రెజెంటర్ కనిపించాడు నాకు రిక్వెస్ట్ పంపించడానికి నేను రైట్ క్లిక్ కొట్టాను అన్నమాట అక్కడ నాకు కనబడట్లేదు అది జనరల్ గా అది కనిపిస్తుంది కానీ కనబడట్లేదు అన్నమాట
Hello. Hello. I'm not able to see the trainer.
Sorry, Justin, for inconvenience.
Okay, it's fine. Okay, you have the control.
Yeah, I have the controls.
Okay.
So this was the link. It was not opening on my machine, if you would have observed.
Yeah.
Why again? Went twice. Did you click on the do not install, or have you?
No, no, no. I did not do anything.
For the first time, this will take like this, but okay.
So which database are we using for this one?
What just say?
Which database we are using? MySQL?
No. MySQL is a free database. We don't use that. DB2 or Oracle.
Okay. No. When you are starting the training, you will install the data stage, right? In my system.
Yes. So in that they will install the Oracle.
Oracle. Okay. Yes. So and that data stage does have a license also, right? Or is it a free?
Yes. Okay. So yes, we have connected to the remote machine.
Okay.
So let me just open the desktop so that I'll show you how the components they look like.
Okay.
Yeah. Here you can see the designer client. I am just highlighting it.
Okay.
Okay. So this is the director client, and okay. We have something called as administrator client. Can you see them?
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So designer client is used for designing the data state jobs. So I said from director you can monitor, schedule, and all. So when you double click on the designer client, it will ask you for the server details where your data state engine is installed. Since it is a client server architecture. So the client components installed on this machine and the server will be installed on the another machine.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So you need to specify those credentials, server name, username, password, and you should give the project to which you would like to connect to.
Okay. So when it is installing in my system, what will be the server?
So for you, the local, your system itself, the server and you, it is like server and the client become the same machine.
Yeah, got it.
Got it, right? So that is a one-tier architecture. We call it as a one-tier architecture.
Yeah.
If the client and server is installed on one machine, two-tier architecture, like if the client is installed on one machine and server is installed on another machine.
Okay.
Similarly, we have three-tier architecture even. So in the server, again, you have some components, repository and data stage engine. If the repository is installed on one machine and the engine is installed on another machine, then it becomes the three-tier architecture.
Okay.
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 So now when I double click on this, it will open this particular data designer window.
Okay.
So this is the designer window. In the designer window, you can see repository where whatever the jobs that you create, you can find them in the repository.
Okay.
So repository is a place where we can see all the data stage items.
Okay, I got it.
So yeah, so you can see some sort of jobs here. So like server jobs, sequence jobs, and parallel jobs. By looking at the symbol, if it is a green color, then it is a sequence job. Red color, it is a parallel job. Okay, yellow for server job.
Okay.
Okay. So I said the job contains the set of stages. So let me open one parallel job and I will show you how the stages looks like.
Okay.
So the one you can see now, right, it is a sequence job. The one which you can see now.
Okay.
Okay. So in the sequence job, if you want to execute any batch scripts, then we have the stage. So that is the command stage. So inside this particular stage, we will write the command, which command you would like to execute.
Okay.
Okay. So if it is, if your data stage is installed on Windows, then it would be a Windows commands. If it is installed on Unix, then it would be Unix commands.
Okay.
Okay.
And the command Windows commands means?
DOS commands.
DOS commands. Okay.
Okay. So now let me open one parallel job, very simple and small parallel job, extracting the data from the file, doing some small transformations on a row by row basis and populating that data into the table.
Okay.
So this is the job. Now this is the stage. So each and every stage is linked, if you observe here.
Okay. Yeah.
Right. So it means that from the file, we are, first stage is the file stage. So from the file, you are extracting the data, and the second one is the transformation stage. So you can do the transformations. You can apply one-to-one transformations, and then the third one is the database stage, and then you load the data into the table. Okay.
Okay.
So here, then we'll get into the director one. So director, in from the director, we can see the status of the jobs. Like if the job is finished successfully, then the status will be finished.
Okay. Yeah.
If the job is failed, then the status will becomes aborted.
Okay.
Okay. If you want to see why the job is failed, then we can check the logs.
Okay. Yeah. Got it.
Okay. And from the data stage director, from this director window, you can add the data stage jobs to your schedule. So here you can see some clock symbol.
Okay, yeah.
Okay. So from the clock symbol, you can add the jobs to the schedule. Add to schedule.
Okay.
Okay. Automatically, the job gets executed. So whenever that type particular time encounters.
Okay.
Okay. So this is about the complete overview of the data stage. So do you have any questions?
No, I think I am good with this.
Okay.
So you will be installing the Oracle database as well as the data stage shapefile, right?
Everything will be taken care by us.
Okay, so after the training also, I'll be able to use that, right?
It will be installed on your machine, so you can use it.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, Justin. Yeah, I'll just pass this call to the Teja. Teja, are you online? Okay, Justin, I am leaving from the meeting. You can just talk to the Teja, okay?
Okay, okay. Ask him to call me.
So he's the concerned person. You can talk to him.
Okay, sure. Yeah.
Yeah. Thanks, Justin. Okay. It's nice talking to you.
Session. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. It's nice talking to you.
Yeah. Have a good day. Bye.
Okay. Yeah,
let me just close this particular machine, my machine.
Okay.
Bye, Justin.
Okay. Okay, see you. Bye.